Today I'm going to show you how to get started with Azure Machine Learning Studio. Go to the Azure ML homepage, which is a collection of links and videos, including what's new, how to access help, and how you can participate in our forums. To sign into the Azure ML Studio, click on the Studio or Sign In links at the top of the page. You will need to sign in using your Microsoft account. Please remember to use the Microsoft account that was used to create your workspace. Once you have signed in with your Microsoft account, you will see the browser-based workbench, which is Azure ML Studio. Let's take a quick tour. ML Studio has three sections: Experiments, Web Services, and Settings. The Experiments section is where you will author predictive analytics experiments and spend most of your time. The Web Services section is where you can see a list of web services you've created. And finally, the Settings section is where you can change the settings for your workspace and share your workspace with your team members. The Experiments section shows all the experiments in your workspace, with the experiments that you've been editing most recently at the top of the list. If you want to delete an experiment, select the experiment and then click on the Delete icon at the bottom of the page. Your workspace comes pre-populated with samples. If you click on Samples, you will see the list of sample experiments available to you. By clicking on a sample experiment, you can see it with all of its modules. You can clone the experiment and save an editable file of the experiment by clicking on the Save As button at the bottom of the page. The first step for building a predictive model is uploading a dataset. The new icon at the bottom of the page allows you to do just that. Click on Dataset, from Local File, and you will see a dialog where you can upload datasets in multiple file formats. I'm going to import a dataset by pointing to a CSV file that I have on my local disk. I confirm the name of the dataset, and I select Generic CSV File with a header. I now see an indication that a new dataset is being uploaded. The New button at the bottom of the page also allows you to create a new experiment. Let's go ahead and create a new blank experiment. The first thing you want to do is give your experiment a name. The left side of the experiment canvas has a palette of modules that are available to you to build an experiment. You can look through the predefined categories to select a module for building your experiment, or you can search these modules for a specific keyword. Let's select a module. I want to read data from an Azure blob, so I'm going to search for the Reader module and then drag the module onto the main experiment canvas. The right pane of the experiment canvas shows me the properties for this module. I want to read data from Azure Blob Storage using a public URI. This is where I can specify the URI for the dataset. The dataset is in the CSV format, so I'm good here. Once I'm done with that, I can hit Run at the bottom of the page, which will run this module for me. To continue building my experiment, I drag another module onto the canvas. I want to run descriptive statistics on the data I just read, so I search for this module and I drag it onto the main canvas. To connect it, I drag the output port of the Reader module and connect it to the input port of the descriptive statistics module. I can also right-click on the output port of every module in my experiment. By doing so, I see a menu and can select Visualize that will show a summary of the output from that module. Let's take a look at the Web Services section next. I have one web service. I click on the service, which brings me to a dashboard for the service. The page lists the parent experiment that was used to build the service. The page also lists the API access key needed for calling the service. Finally, the page lists both the request response and batch execution service. The API help page for the service lists the OData endpoint and the request URI for the service. The page also lists a sample request in JSON. At the bottom of the page, you will find sample code in C#, Python, and R for calling the service. The configuration page for this service is where you can go to change the service configuration and description of the input and output parameters. Finally, let's take a look at the settings section. This is where you can invite other users to your workspace. Clicking on the users link will take you to this page. To invite coworkers to your workspace, you can click on the Invite More Users button on the bottom of the page and type in their Microsoft account email address. You can also decide if you want this user to have user or owner permissions. A user has permission to list, clone, and create experiments and datasets in your workspace. An owner can also add, remove, and list users with access to the workspace in addition to what a user can do. Once the invitation has been sent, you will see the user listed here with their role and status. If you wish to remove a user from your workspace, you simply have to select them and click on Remove, which will withdraw their access from your workspace. Once a user has been invited to a workspace, they will receive an email with a link to access your workspace. They will need to click on this invitation link in the email to access your workspace. If you have been invited to someone else's workspace, you'll be able to see the additional workspaces in the drop-down here. Thanks for watching.